On assumption of office in 2015, the present government said it was not embarking on new infrastructure development. Rather, it promised to complete abandoned projects which dot the landscape, and they are legion. Again, these structures are capital intensive, and to effectively accomplish this onerous task, the federal government is planning a road infrastructure tax so as to rehabilitate and maintain these said projects. The executive chairman of the Federal Inland Revenue Service, FIRS, Mohammed Nami, maintained that the only way to make the informal sector contribute to building a modern society is by making people pay for infrastructure use. It's a logical reasoning, Paul, if you ask me.
It's a logical reasoning, but I'm a little bit skeptical. Of course, we are saying that the federal government should look for other sources of getting revenue instead of borrowing. But this particular, as laudable as it seems, you know, as laudable as it seems to me, there are questions that are on my mind. One, okay, you are saying that those who operate in the informal sector, maybe such as hairdressers or so, should contribute and all of that. Some of these people even have a hard time getting power. So they spend a lot of money, you know, getting alternative power, you know, because they can't rely on the electricity. They're already spending much money. Some of them are also paying levies at the local government level. I hope it does not, because we don't know what method you will use to get this tax. But I hope it doesn't end up becoming...
Is it necessarily true that Nigerians don't love paying tax?
I wouldn't say it is. Of course, we have a lot of tax evaders. But I think if Nigerians see dividends of, as they call it, dividends of democracy, of course, they can be persuaded to do what they ought to do.
The picture you're seeing is not one of them.
Okay, so
you're talking about dividends.
It's our road, man.
It's our road. Now, when people see this kind of thing, they'll just say, look, they are chopping our money. That's that. They say they are chopping our money.
But at the same time, we need to fix these roads.
We need to fix these roads. There are so many other ways of raising revenue. We have redundant assets that can. We said the last time I came here, I think we were talking about some of this. Well, I wouldn't say that they shouldn't go ahead, but I just want to see how it's going to look like. But I'm just a little bit skeptical, because the people we want to get money from are already, they are being levied at the very micro level, and they are not even getting joy. They are not getting joy from government in many aspects.
Jide, there's a marked difference between a good sounding proposition and a proposition that sounds good. So he's expressing diffidence about how to go about this new tax regime.
Well, anything that will help us achieve better road network in our country, I'm going to support it. These roads have taken many lives. We have the highest fatality rates on talking about roads in Africa. By a 2010 survey, the fatality rate on Nigerian roads was put at 33.7 per 100,000. That's quite high. People can't get to work early. People are dying in installments because of the number of hours they spend on the road.
Is that of a federal road?
Yes, that's a federal road. A lot of the, I remember the Senate told the president to declare a state of emergency on federal roads, because we have 120,540 miles of roads in our country.
Yeah.
Road network, 120,540. And a good portion of these are federal roads, and they are in a terrible state. We have the worst roads in Africa. Now, what do we do? We've got to get the private sector more and more involved in helping us to fix roads. The Dangote example that was used in Abajana in Kogi State.
Yeah.
He gave Kogi State a concrete road. That road has been there for years, and there is not a single bump on that road, not a single pothole. That's to tell you how long the concrete
road. Look at this one. This is a good road.
Yes. That's to tell you how long-lasting concrete roads are. Mm. You can see that even here in Lagos, from Apapa, Dangote is building concrete roads again. And when you even drive on those roads, you can feel it. You enjoy the driving. So we need to give such people tax holidays. Big corporate concerns, give them tax holidays, encourage them to fix roads. I'm happy that Globacom is already in talks to fix one of the most problematic roads in Ogun State. We need to do a lot more of that. We will never find enough funds to fix all our roads. The funds are simply not there.
Yeah.
So we have to look at alternative means. Talk about infrastructure tax. How he intends to do it has not already been communicated to everyone. I'm sure even at the level of National Assembly, they will have a say in this. But it's a good thing that they're also bringing back the toll plazas.
Mm-hmm.
Because from the money that you make, you can at least give the people decent roads.
Yeah.
You know, you can maintain the roads, you can rehabilitate the roads, you can even reconstruct, as we are doing with the Lagos-Ibadan Expressway.
Yeah.
A road that was constructed in 1978 or so, or 79. We do not expect that it should remain in that old state.
Mm.
The population is a lot...
But that's supposed to be the busiest road in West Africa.
Yes, it still is.
Mm.
It still is. But now we have expanded it, you know, in line with population growth.
That's it.
Not in tandem with economic growth. We have expanded it. Now, by the time they finish that road, hopefully in 2022, Nigerians will enjoy that road a lot more. But we also look at the Badagry corridor.
We need
to do something. We need to find the money, complete that road. It's the Nigerian side of it that is shameful. Once you get beyond Nigeria, you see how beautiful.
Yeah. I don't think you are forgetting Agege Motor Road to Abeokuta. That road should have been fixed. It's also another busy road.
Of course it is. But a lot of people, you know, if you are going to Abeokuta from that end, it's fast. It's only about 70 kilometers from there, and it's a dual carriageway.
Mm.
But huge portions of that road has failed.
Oh, yeah,
so people would rather not go to Abeokuta through that route. They would rather go through the problematic Lagos Expressway here.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So my concern is, let's get the roads
fixed
so that the hemorrhage of lives on our roads will at least go down drastically.
That's
why I support the idea. I know that paying tax, you see, the culture of paying tax, it needs to be well ingrained in our country.
Mm.
In Europe and America, you dare not do tax evasion.
Oh, yeah.
In some countries of the world, the price you pay for tax evasion is higher than manslaughter.
That's it.
The punishment is higher than manslaughter. But in our country, big companies bribe their way, they fail to pay tax, they are not ready. They just call tax officials, give them some money, they refuse to pay.
They take it and that's it.
They refuse to pay, and they are sabotaging their country.
That's it.
We need to get more people into the tax net.
Okay.
So that I can earn more money.
Oh, why not? Why not?
We should also avoid multiple taxation. So everything has to be very done.
But you have agreed that many Nigerians don't like
many
to pay
don't
tax.
Pay. I'm yes, telling I, you
I,
now.
No, I don't disagree with you.
I
don't disagree what you are saying. I don't disagree with you. But beyond people paying taxes, we want to see what they are using taxes for.
It's only natural.
You will see.
It's only natural.